G'day folks, Ren here, and it is time for my January TBR. It actually feels really weird to be doing a TBR video where I'm not doing a TBR game, but as you can see, I'm not in my usual area, so I'm currently in England visiting Kirsty, so I didn't bring TBR Gate with me. TBR Gate will be back hopefully in February. I am doing a update of the whole game, so if I can finish that before February, then TBR Gate will be back for then. But for now, no game, just the TBR. So I've got a few things happening in January. So first of all, it is going to be the start of the Hitchhikers read-along that I'm a co-host with Mel from A Book Fiend Named Mel, Ash from Ash's Adventures in Books, Chelsea from Chelsea Zhao, and Ashley from Ashley's Media Addiction. So the first book, obviously, is The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, so I will be reading that in January. The live show is going to be on Mel's channel. I will link my announcement video down below so you can get all the details from that. The other thing happening in January is Adventurathon, which is hosted by Kirsty from K-Beth Bookish.
Adventurers assemble!
Yeah! So this is going to be the first round of an actual adventure. The previous rounds that we've had, we were building our characters, but now it is time to actually go on an adventure, which is going to be awesome. But there is also Bookimon, which is a year-long read-along hosted by Meredith from Reading with Merb. And while this is a year-long readathon, there are some set things that you can do each month to get specific Bookimon. I am going to be attempting to collect a few Bookimon in January as well. Let's start with Adventurathon. So the one mandatory read that you have to complete is the Guildhall prompt. And for this, there are four different tables that you could sit at, and you just have to choose which table you would like to sit at and then pick a book that fits the vibe of that table. Now, the table that my character, Valdor of the Stray Mountains, will be staying at is the happy-go-lucky group of people, the ones that are loud and boisterous and they're having a fun old time. The book I'm choosing for this prompt is Restart After Coming Back Home by Kakumi. This is a queer manga that I am very keen to read. It's one of Kirsty's manga, which one of the third or fourth best things about being here is getting to read all of Kirsty's manga. So look out for that vlog coming in January. So this seems to be about a guy coming back to his hometown after he's not done too well in life recently. So he's coming back home to figure things out. And he meets another guy there and feelings happen. But it seems like it's also going to be really emotional, which you might not think would fit the prompt. But I asked our Lord and Savior, Kirsty, and she said this would fit. Because apparently the love interest is a very kind of happy, bubbly person. So if it fits, it sits. Then the next place that I'll be going is the Elderglade. And the prompt for that is to read a book featuring a magical or enchanted forest. Now, Kirsty stretched hers, so I'm going to do the same thing because we will be buddy reading the Lovelight Farms book by B.K. Borison. Now, the way Kirsty described it was, you know, they're falling in love in a Christmas tree farm, and what's more magical than that? So that's what I'm going to do because we got to get this book on our TBRs because, yeah, we're going to read it together and have a really great time reading cute stuff together while being cute. So yeah, this is basically what I just said. It is a romance between these two people who do like a fake dating thing, which is my favorite trope ever, and they do it in a Christmas tree farm, which sure, okay. But I've heard really good things about this. Everyone seems to really enjoy it, so we're gonna give it a go. Then the next prompt is for Ilaria Ruins, and the prompt for that is to read a book where history is pivotal to the plot. And you can stretch that in any way that you want to, but the way that I've chosen to interpret this one is like an ancient curse that's like coming back to bite you in the ass. So for this, I'll be reading Blood Ties by Elizabeth Christensen and Sunny Whitelaw. This is book 8, I believe, in the Stargate Atlantis novel series, which I've been reading and enjoying. It's a great time. I really want to catch up on this series because I only read one or two books in 2023, So in 2024, I'd like to read way more of this series, but this is obviously about Stargate Atlantis, my favorite TV show. And these are just kind of, you could almost think of them as they would have been episodes in the TV show, but they didn't get to it. So they're just like little extra missions. And in this one, I believe the team has gone back to Earth because there is apparently a wraith on planet Earth, which is scary. Our lovely, lovely Daniel Jackson makes an appearance as well, my fave. And they uncover this kind of ancient curse. And I'm really looking forward to getting back into this series because it's so good. And I really wish I'd read more of it in 2023. Then the next place is Cast Village, where the prompt is to read a book where the title has like a place name in it. So for this, I'm going to read Gallant by V.E. Schwab. Gallant is like the name of the house that this person goes to, so it counts. I don't super know what this is about, but I own it. I want to read it. I really want to give V.E. Schwab more chances because I seem to kind of only give them like 3 stars, even though the premise always sounds amazing.
Ooh.
I haven't read your favorite yet.
I don't like Schwab or anything.
No, it's not an entire dedicated shelf or nothing. For Gallant, it seems to be this person inherits a house mansion thing, and I'm assuming there'll be potential hauntings. Maybe. It looks like a kind of creepy read, which I'm always here for. And there seems to be some kind of, I think like don't go in the woods surrounding the house. I don't know. I really don't know much about these books and I can't look them up because I'm filming on my phone. So the next place I'll be going is Sage's Retreat, which the prompt for this was to do a random letter generator. And the letter that I got for this was the letter C. So for this, I'm going to read Can I Steal You for a Second by Jodie McAllister. This is a book I've had for a little while, and I think I first heard about it from Sash Reads. And even though this is the second book in a series, I think it's one of those romance series where you can read it in whatever order you want. And this is a sapphic romance set in Australia, which is ticking all the boxes for me. But it's also about a dating show where instead of falling for the, like, the bachelor, basically, of the show, these two women contestants end up falling for each other, which sounds like a great time to me. And I'm really looking forward to this one. And, like, more Australian queer books? Yes, please. The next up is Everglow Falls. So the prompt for that was to have water and a source of light on the cover. And everyone seems to be hating me for making up this prompt, which I think is hilarious. I have a great time with how stressful this is for everyone. It's a good time.
Especially Jonah.
Yeah, so sorry, Jonah, but also not sorry at all, in the slightest. But the book I chose for this is Melt by Elle Fountain. This is a like middle grade survivalist story, which I love survival stories. And this one is, I think, set in Antarctica. And the synopsis was a little bit confusing because I think there's 2 kids that we're following, but I think they're in different places. But then they somehow come together at the same place, but it doesn't make sense. I don't know. It's very confusing. So it seems to be about this boy that gets stuck on an iceberg and then somehow has to survive with that. But then in the synopsis, it seemed to say that this girl who was somewhere else then somehow ended up on the iceberg as well. I mean, it's a survival story. I want to read it. And it sounds like an interesting time. Then the last of the main quest prompts is the Well of Fortune, which the prompt for that is a source of magic. Now for this, I'm going to be reading Spellhacker by M.K. England. So this is a queer fantasy book, which I am very excited for, even though I've owned it for several years and still haven't read it. But this seems to be that magic is a natural resource that comes from just the earth, but I think it's not as available as it used to be. So people are kind of scrounging around for magic. This new source of magic comes out of the earth? I'm not sure. And then everyone's trying to get that as well. It's a little complicated and they say Maz for magic, but I have read an M.K. England book before and I really, really enjoyed it. So I'm hoping I will like this one as well. So that is all of the main quest books that I'll be reading, and I'm not going to talk about any of the side quest books yet because at the time of this being posted, I don't think you know about the side quests. Okay, so then on to the Bookemon prompts that I'm going to be trying to get in January. So first up is obviously the January prompt. So there are monthly Bookemon that you can get. So to get the January Bookemon, you have to get the Pacifier, which to do that, you got to read like a children's book, middle grade, picture book, whatever. So for this, I will read Melt because that is a middle grade. So, and then we also got the seasonal prompts. So the season that Pokemon world, or is this the world? I don't know. The Pokemon are currently in the winter season or the snow season. So we have a few different Pokemon that we can try to lure out in this time. But in January specifically, I'm only going to be trying to lure out one of the Pokemon. I don't know which one. I'll find out once I lure it. But the two prompts that I'm going for, the first one is Telescope. And the prompt for that is to read a book with the night sky on the cover. And for that, I will read The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, because no matter what edition I'm able to get, there is some kind of night sky on it, because obviously this is a sci-fi. I mean, you'll see, obviously, here. But there is like a starry sky in the writing, but then also in the cup, there is a galaxy. So that's night sky enough for me. Then the next prompt that I need to get to lure out a Pokemon is a Christmas tree. And for that, I have to read a sparkly book. So for this, I'm going to choose Spell Hacker because the title seems to be some kind of metallic object. I don't know. It seems like it could be shiny if it was in the real world. So I'm just going to take it. And then we have the regular Pokemon prompts that sometimes you need to read them in certain orders. So the first one is the Volcanic Rock prompt. And for that, you have to read a book from 6 different book clubs. And for this, I'm going to be starting in January with the Big Bad Booty Bitches book club, I think is what it's called. But the book that they're going to be reading in January is Mayfly by S.G. Lead. And oh my god, I've been wanting to read this for such a long time. I mean, like, just the cover. The cover looks amazing. It's been getting some really good reviews from a lot of horror booktubers that I watch, like especially Katie. She loves it. So I'm like, okay, I need to read that. I can't even really tell you what this is about because I didn't care what it was about. I saw the cover. I wanted to read it. But it seems to be a bit of a story about this girl who was kind of always doing the right thing until she decided she didn't want to anymore. And then I think she goes on a little bit of a rampage, which I'm here for. But it sounds like it's going to be awesome. I've been hearing such good things about it. And then the last thing for Pokemon that I'm going to try and get in January is the chicken prompt. So for the chicken prompt, you have to read one book every month of the year that has white, black, and yellow or orange on the cover. So for this, I'm going to read The Promised Neverland, Volume 1 by Kayu Shirai. That's probably horrendously wrong, I'm very sorry. But this is a manga that I've been told to read for a long time and I keep not picking it up, but it seems to be a bit of a horror manga, which I'm here for that. And I think it's about these children in an orphanage and they're always told not to go into the forest. Lots of forest things happening this month, but that's okay. And I think they do go into the forest and really find out how messed up it is and what the people caring for them are doing. Not sure. Sounds like it could be very creepy, and that's all I kind of want from books. So that's going to be it for my January TBR. I am also going to be reading a whole bunch of manga, but that'll all be in a separate vlog because I don't even know exactly what I'll be reading yet because the choice will be up to Kirsty. That's going to be it for January's TBR, and thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next one. Bye!